Hi, I'm Dylighted, and today I wanted to talk about a theoretical concept that really hasn't been discussed before. I'm going to be introducing two different types of coastal settlements in Catan. If you play around on a board, you start to realize that the most crowded scenario is if you place a settlement on the corner of every single spot. So sort of like 854, the 569, the 3611, the 8310, the 2910, and the 649. So, if you have six settlements like this, you end up closing the entire middle off, and you force two more players to go on the coast in a four-player game. Usually, on an outer desert board, there are some open three-hex spots left. However, in this most crowded scenario, you're forced to take a coastal spot, as there's nothing else left. So, I wanted to name these corner spots that make this formation, so I decided to call them a blocking settlement. And placing on these spots, like the 854, the 569, the 6311, you block settlements, which is why it's called a blocking settlement, because you block settlement spots. Now, this is different than the traditional triangle road settlement. The 346 is a great example of a triangle road settlement. As you usually point your road towards the coast here, you can expand to the 3 ore and the 6 wheat, making a little triangle road. So, there are two types of settlements I'm going to be going over. The triangle road settlement, which is a 346, and then the blocking settlement, which is the 469, or something like the 569. So this is a pretty cool discovery and all, but I was asking myself, how can this be applied in Catan? How can I use this in the competitive scene to help advance the strategy and push forward the meta? And that's sort of when I realized that the more triangle road settlements there are, the more open space there is on the board. So in theory, you can predict the number of open 3-hex settlement spots based on the number of triangle road settlements and blocking settlements. So let's take a look at an example of what I'm talking about. In this scenario, we see we have completely locked the board and this theoretical placement of 6 settlements. Of course, there still needs to be 2 more settlements in that 4-player game. But for now, let's just go ahead with these 6 settlements. Let's go ahead and shift the 469 to the 346. We've moved this settlement from a blocking settlement to a triangle road settlement. Now you see that we've actually opened a triple hex spot, the 4911, and the 69, but it's a desert spot. So we went from having 0 triple hex spots to now having 1. So now how do we exactly apply this and use this in a game? So this is all pretty theoretical, but let's say you're playing in the first position and you really want a triple hex spot as your last pick. So maybe instead of placing a blocking settlement, you place a triangle road settlement. So instead of the 469, you go on the 346. So when it comes back to you as the 8th pick, there's now a triple hex spot open. Now, that application is pretty theoretical, as it's hard to control and predict where other people will place, especially as the first position. So here's a more practical application. As a wood brick player, you can intentionally place a triangle road settlement to create more space on the board. This will allow you to artificially create a strong third settlement spot on the board, instead of having to expand to the coast if it's crowded. If that didn't make sense, that's okay. Here's an example. Let's go to this board state real quick. As fourth position here, you get to place 2 settlements. So if you go in the 9510, which is a triangle road settlement, it opens up more space on the board as we discussed earlier. So now as a second settlement as fourth position, you can place on the 6311 wood and point inward towards the board instead of actually pointing towards the coast. The reason why you can point your road inwards is because by placing on the 9510 instead of the 569, you actually create a new settlement spot. So now you can expand to the 31011 and the 5611. So by shifting your settlements just a little bit, by using a triangle road settlement, instead of a blocking settlement, you create another spot for yourself to expand to. This is really critical as a road player, as you need strong third settlements. This is your way to match the strong production against the cities, the traditional ore wheat sheep players. In addition, another benefit of pointing your road inwards for the 3611 is that you not only start off with the free road, you threaten both of these open spots. You're concentrated on tons of wood and brick, so people would be discouraged to race you. Now, if you're worried that the 3-10-11 and the 5-6-11 will be taken, let's go ahead and place this out. Combining this concept we're about to learn with predicting where your opponents will place, can result to some amazing improvements in your game. So let's do it. So we see in third position that a pretty reasonable spot for them to go is the 6-9-12 or the 3-4-8. I think both of them are pretty viable. Let's just say that they go in the 6-9-12 because there's more wood to match with their high brick. Now at second position, pick 7, they have a choice of where they go. Since there's so many open spots on this board, let's just say that they'll go on the 4-9-11, as it gives them the resources that they're missing. I think that this is a pretty reasonable spot. The 5-6-11 isn't actually that good for them, as even if they have all that brick to go at the brick port, no one is going to trade them the 2 woods and the sheep for them to be on the brick port, as it's so scary since they have 3 spots of brick. I think the more reasonable play here is to go on the 4-9-11, as it gets you sheep that you don't have, it gets you wood to pair with your brick, and it gives you an extra wheat tile to give you a sufficient source of wheat. I think most players would place on the 4-9-11 here. I think another potential option that second position can choose is a 3-4-8. But I still think that the 4-9-11 is more likely, as you can expand to the 6-9, which is strong. While the 3-4-8 isn't bad, I still think the 4-9-11 is more reasonable and more likely. So let's just assume that second position goes in the 4-9-11. Now we rotate back to pick 8, the first position. So let's look at first position's options. They can go on the 3-10-11 and the 3-4-8. I think it's pretty unlikely for first position to take the 3-10-11, as once again, they don't have much road material to get to their desired port. No one's going to be trading them the bricks and wood for them to get on the wheat port, as it's very scary once they get on the wheat port. Now you might argue that first and fourth position might trade wheat for bricks, but you're forgetting the fact that other people have wheats on this board. Other people will make a defensive trade to prevent first position to get on that scary wheat port. It also doesn't really make much sense for first position to go on the 5-6-11. The reason for this is because you have so much brick and you don't have any wood to go with it. And if you go on the 5-6-11, you're going to be instantly cut off by fourth position. I think the most reasonable spot as first position is just going on the 3-4-8 and then using that free road to get yourself on the wheat port. As first position, you might be tempted to point your road towards the 3-10-11 to get on more wheat, but you're in a race with 4th position who has insane amounts of wood and brick. I think it's suicide to try to race for the 3-10-11. But the thing is, if 4th position didn't point the road inwards and pointed it towards a coast or somewhere else, then as 1st position, you have the 3-10-11 open. Once again, as a wood brick player, you need to point your road aggressively towards the open spots, as it gets you massive rewards if you do it correctly. So you see, adjusting from a blocking settlement to a triangle road settlement, it leads you massive rewards like the 5-6-11 being open and the 3-10-11 being open, which are both uncontested. We can see the same concept of triangle road settlements and blocking settlements be applied in one of my earlier videos featuring Like the Groundhog. In one of his tournament sets, he strategically placed on 3 numbers and only 3 resources, but they were blocking settlements,
locking his opponents out of strong wood, brick, and sheep. In this situation, you see Like the Groundhog doing 2 blocking settlements in order to force his opponents into suboptimal positions. This was a 3-player game where there's more space, and he still successfully managed to lock a large portion of the board. He saw the value of locking brick, wood, and sheep from his opponents, which led him to winning this 3-player game.
Let's talk about the lesson objectives of this video. The first lesson objective is for you to be able to define and identify blocking settlements and triangle road settlements. It is imperative for you to use these when you're stuck in the fourth position playing wood brick. The second lesson is to be able to apply and use triangle road settlements to create open spaces on the board for you to expand on as a wood brick player. The last lesson objective is to apply and utilize blocking settlements and practicing how to lock a large amount of the board as the fourth position, forcing your opponents to get in suboptimal positions. This concept between these 2 settlements is especially important as 4th position. As in this heavy ore wheat sheep dominant meta, as 4th position, a lot of the times you're forced to go wood brick. When you're in 4th position, you have to make a decision of whether to go triangle road settlements and open spots on the board for you to expand to, or make the decision to go on blocking settlements, locking other people out of critical resources and having them go through a suboptimal game. It is imperative for you to use these concepts and apply them to your own wood brick game, especially when you're in the fourth position and you can coordinate strong blocking settlements or create artificial open spots with the triangle road settlements. So this is a cool little concept and application to help you improve your wood brick game. As so far in the channel, I've been focusing on ore wheat sheep strategy, but I really want to expand more on the strategy for wood and brick. The last thing I want to mention is that there are three types of board in Settlers of Catan. There's the outer desert board, which is this one. There's the second ring desert board, which is this one. And then, of course, there's the center desert board, which is this one. The application of triangle road settlement and blocking settlements change per the board type. But to keep this video short, I'm not going to go into the three types of board and how this changes things. For now, I just want to show you the two types of coastal settlements and how you can use it in your game. I hope this is useful for you and makes you think about the inner workings of Catan and why things occur the way they do. There really is a lot more strategy and depth that goes into this game that people just don't see. Anyways, I'm trying my best to make as many videos for y'all as I've been absent for the past month or two. Thank you so much for sticking with me and watching my videos. If you learned something, please show me some feedback by liking the video or letting me know what you learned in the comments. Thank you. I'm Dylighted, and I hope you learned something.